can open and close the windows anytime you want. Please don't close them. This is the hottest day it's been up here so far. So, you guys are very fortunate. And I can almost see the summit. Last train, couldn't see a thing. So things are looking good. You can come up to this doorway anytime you want, take pictures. Just please do not step on the platform. For safety purposes, I might be taking a nap. I don't want you to step on my head. Little girl thinks I'm serious. Now she just figured out I'm not. With a serious look to a smile, it was precious. Now I figure what the heck I was saying. I don't know. Anybody have any questions? No?
Why were they unloading train track parts?
Say what?
Why were they unloading steel from the back of the train?
Where?
On the back of the engine, they were unloading a bunch of steel. Do you guys do maintenance routinely?
Yes, every night after the, well, during the day, there's a crew of two that does it, but every night, the crew goes up, works till midnight. You'll see the scraps on the side. And every morning, we go up and pick up all the scraps, bring them back down, recycle them. Sir, it's nothing to worry about. It's not a fast roller coaster, sir. Please stay calm. So we have that young lady talk to you. She's only two, but she'll come to you now. Let's see what's going on here. If I like you, yes, you can stay an hour up there. I suggest you stay about 50 minutes, though. I don't want you to miss your train. Let me see what this is. The cleanest water you're going to find anywhere. The origin is two lakes up in the mountains called Lakes of the Clouds. This water is just cleaner than clean. It travels about 55 miles to the Connecticut River that empties out in the Long Island Sound. We're going. Hold on for a minute. Hold on to those kids. Feel that thrust of energy on the roller coaster of the Cog Railway. That's it, honey. That's as fast as we go. You should bring her up here. Let her look out the door. Show her the exciting pile of rocks that we've stacked up here. He's gonna blow his horn or not, so how fast are we going, guys? Anybody know? Of course, now he blows his horn. Six? No. Eight? No.
Two?
Ten? No.
Two?
Four? No. I give up. Everybody wave to me. Wave to me, everybody. Everybody. Hey, you're all smart. 5 miles an hour. Did you wave to me? I have a designated person I pick on every train ride. You're in without the two, the one missing two. All right, everybody's wondering how this works. Behind us is an engine with a 650 horsepower John Deere diesel marine engine. There's four cogs on it. Cog looks like what's on the side of the bench. That star-shaped thing is a gear. We have four of them on the bottom, two for brakes, two for power forward. We have a center rack in the middle of the track here, made out of two L-shaped pieces of steel with metal. What the heck is that? The moose!
Oh, it's not a real one.
Look at that! It's a real live plastic moose. You want to hear the backstory on a plastic moose? We had a moose up here from a taxi driver. It looked really real. It looked so real that a real life moose came up and tried to befriend him. For a 2-day period, the taxi driver moose showed no signs of affection in return. So the real moose just wandered away after 2 days. Well, the problem is we left the bad boy out for the winter and he kind of fell apart. We had to bury him. So we replaced him with a plastic moose, hoping to generate new interest in the area, but so far, no takers. That's my story, I'm sticking to it. A gentleman named Sylvester Marsh is responsible for this Cog Railway. Came up here hiking one day, and got to the very top, met with a storm. almost lost his life. Got to the top stairs of the tip-top house. Had dinner and stayed overnight and breakfast. He and his hiking partner, who was his minister, came out the next morning and saw a crystal clear day. You see the United Ocean, Canada, and five different states. He said at that point, he's going to get the public up here to enjoy this beauty. So he came back here, went to Concord, got a charter to put this in, hired 300 men from the Civil War, who just ended. Took 3 years and built this Cogway as you see it. But it was not successful. Back then, trains were brand new, they were high tech. No one believed you could pull a train up a mountain, because back then, trains just went flat and they went fast. Well, he proved them wrong because they had two United States presidents to ride the train. And everybody came from far and wide to see what it was all about. That was the beginning of the tourism between this railway and the Mount Washington carriage route. So, one man's determination got things done. Fought for a very long time. Got it done. And that's why you're riding in the Cog Railway right now, because one man's determination. The Cog system was already invented, but no one made it go up a mountain. So Lester Morris did. You can read his story in the lobby. Water and 1 ton of coal every time it goes up.
Where are the trains? Oh, they're coming down.
Bring the engineer up to the step, and I'll crawl out for you at that point you can get up and help you disembark the train. So two things to remember right now is just please stay seated. We'll be back in about 50 minutes, okay? Thank you all very much for being with me today. I deeply appreciate it. Hope you have a wonderful time up there and have great experiences.
They're so high up in the air.
And coach are not connected. So my coach actually has a flat plate. His engine has a bumper wheel. He guides us down, we're on grades. Right now we use the chain until we get to that grade. So we'll be, you'll feel like a bumper car situation until we get there, and then we'll pull off the chain and then go down. I just wanna make sure, when you felt the bumping, you're like, what's going on? Just wanna make sure you knew, and we'll be heading down. As soon as it gets to the other side, we will actually start heading down. Right now there's the steam engine. They are the first trip in the morning, the last train in the afternoon. They are a little slower than us. We go about 5 miles an hour. They go 3 miles. So we're waiting for them to park on side. They stay with their guests the hour, and then they bring them down. Right now we're just waiting for them to get out of the way so we can continue our journey. So we saw Perry pull the chain out. Captain of the train. Feel that, huh? The highest winds ever recorded has been right up here on top of Mount Washington. That was April of 1934, and that was 231 miles per hour. And that's why they do high wind helicopter training here time to time. So millions of years ago, under here, this area was under water. It was the ocean floor. Whenever the place started moving and the continents moved and the glaciers came through here, the rocks with the salt on it dried up and from mica form. And that's kind of how we got our name. When the early settlers came up here and they saw the sun hitting the mica like it is now, the rocks were shining white. And that's why they call us the White Mountains. A lot of people actually think because there's snow on these mountains 9 months out of the year is why we're the White Mountains. But it's actually some mica in the rocks that the reason why we're called the White Mountains. All day they've pretty much been in the clouds. Next to us is Mount Clay. Next to Mount Clay is Mount Jefferson. Next to Mount Jefferson is Mount Adams. That's the one with the two peaks. The first peak is John Adams Peak. The second peak is John Quincy Adams Peak, making up Mount Adams. Named after the first father-son president. And the most noted one, the small one, where its peak is kind of in the clouds, that is Mount Madison, the most northern presidential mountain. Next to us is the pass by track. This is a part of the tracks where the trains can pass each other. The pass by tracks were actually built in the 1980s. Before then, we used siding. So if trains are going up and they got to the siding, they pull in, they wait for the trains coming down to pass, and then they pull out the siding and then continue their trip to the summit. We have a shop where they've all been built. This has a 600 horsepower John Deere engine. It does all of our braking out momentum for us. It controls the hydraulic pumps that turns our car wheels down the bottom. We have seven coaches. The eighth one's in the coach shop getting built. It's almost done. They just need to finish the floor and put in the benches. And then we'll have eight coaches. And those two were designed here and built right here at the Cog Railway. There's only a few mountain climbing railways in the world, and they all do it the same. There's only a couple that actually use the cog and rack system to get to the top of the mountain. So a lot of it we actually have to fabricate ourselves. So we have some great fabricators who do an amazing job, and that's why we have this amazing equipment that we are using.